This is Copper 90's top 10 worst refereeing decisions of all time. Who among us can say they'd really be a referee? Sure, if you rise up through the ranks, you get to grace the same pitches as some world-class players and experience some of the game's best atmospheres from a unique perspective. Referees can't really win. On the other hand, if you manage to anger the fans of either side, and let's be honest, football fans aren't always the most reasonable in the heat of the moment, you open yourself up to all sorts of trouble. However, there are occasions when refs really do ask for it with incredibly bad calls. These are Copper 90's top 10 worst refereeing decisions of all time. Jeff Hurst versus West Germany. It might be England's defining moment in a sport they're so intrinsically linked to, but let's be honest, it was never over the line. With the scoreboard at 90 minutes reading 2-2 between England and West Germany in the 1966 World Cup final and the game heading into extra time, Jeff Hurst made it 3-2 with the second goal of his eventual hat-trick, with a shot that cannoned down off the crossbar, but as modern studies have shown, did not cross the line. Still, it did pave the way for one of the most iconic lines of commentary ever when Hurst made it 4. Some people are on the pitch, they think it's all over, it is now. Gabriel Torres versus Costa Rica. Still, Jeff Hurst's goal was at least a lot closer than one of the goals that ended USA's World Cup 2018 dream. Costa Rica are one up in a decisive qualifier against Panama, when an in-swinging Panama corner isn't dealt with and causes chaos in the box. In the aftermath, Gabriel Torres attempts to scramble home, but is almost certainly guilty of handling the ball, obstructing it, or maybe both. The ball isn't even partially over the line when it's cleared off Torres and behind, but the goal was given, and a late Panama winner saw them advance to the World Cup finals. Harold Schumacher's challenge on Patrick Battiston. During a World Cup 1982 semi-final between France and West Germany, there was an incident so shocking that it became known as the Tragedy of Seville. Battiston races through on goal for France, and goalkeeper Schumacher comes out to meet him on the edge of the box. Late doesn't even come near to doing it justice. The ball was already practically halfway out of play by the time Schumacher brutally connects with a Frenchman. The challenge was so severe that Battiston lost 3 teeth, slipped into a coma, and still has damaged teeth and a cracked vertebra to this day. The referee didn't even give it as a foul, let alone send Schumacher off. And to rub salt in the wounds, West Germany went on to win on penalties, with Schumacher the hero. Nigel de Jong's tackle on Xabi Alonso. Almost as bad was Nigel de Jong's supposed tackle on Xabi Alonso in the 2010 World Cup final. We get it, it's half an hour into an absolutely massive match, and nobody wants to see such a special game ruined. But Jesus H Christ, you've got to draw the line somewhere. And if that line's not going to be kung fu kicking someone in the chest, you've really got to start asking some questions. Thankfully, for the good of football itself, Howard Webb's decision to only book De Jong didn't go on to affect the result, as Spain took the trophy home thanks to Andres Iniesta's extra time winner. Stefan Kiesling versus Hoffenheim. Ever wondered why linesmen prod the net with their flags before the start of each half? Look no further than Stefan Kiesling's goal against Hoffenheim. It's the modern game, it's the Bundesliga, surely there aren't any holes in the bloody net. Think again. Kiesling's header from a Bayer Leverkusen corner hits the side netting, but somehow comes back through the goal, giving the impression that it's gone in. Embarrassment on Kiesling's part, but minimal protests from Hoffenheim see the goal given, despite the striker telling the referee it shouldn't stand. Reading's ghost goal against Watford. You might have sympathy for the ref on that last one, but surely no one can defend Stuart Atwell, the architect and brains behind the original ghost goal. A run-of-the-mill 2008 championship encounter between Watford and Reading entered the realm of the surreal when then 25-year-old Atwell awarded the Royals the lead when the ball went beyond the line but nowhere near the goal. Looking back, it genuinely takes multiple viewings to even work out where the supposed goal went in. Never has one man and one decision advanced the case for goal line technology so much. Thierry Henry's handball against Ireland. France took a 1-0 lead over Ireland back to the Stade de France for the second leg of their World Cup 2010 playoff match. A Robbie Keane goal meant the match went to extra time and was eventually decided by a controversial William Gallas goal. Thierry Henry blatantly handled the ball to keep it in play before crossing for the centre-half to score. The Irish were furious, but the goal stood. Having got to South Africa in controversial fashion, France then put in one of their least inspiring tournament displays ever and didn't even make it past the group stages. Graham Poll's 3 yellow cards. This one really does defy belief. Widely considered one of his country's best referees, Graham Pohl showed Josip Simonic three yellow cards before sending him off in a World Cup 2002 meeting between Croatia and Australia. They say you should be careful if you're on a yellow, so to get two and then manage to pick up a third is truly impressive. You got to respect Simonic for that. Unsurprisingly, Graham Pohl was sent home from the tournament. The hand of God. This one hardly needs an introduction. The most traumatic moment in England fans' collective memory. Despite being 8 inches shorter than Peter Shilton, Diego Maradona won a 50-50 with the England keeper thanks to what he later called the hand of God during a 1986 World Cup quarter-final in Mexico City. Minutes later, he showed the world the other side of his game with an incredible solo goal, but it's the former that has come to define him, in England at least. The Kieran Gibbs, Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain red card mix-up. When Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain decided to channel his inner goalkeeper, tipping an Eden Hazard shot wide during a meeting between Arsenal and Chelsea, he must have expected to receive his marching orders. Kieran Gibbs, quite rightly, wouldn't have expected any punishment to come his way, but the left-back trudged off for an early bath after Andre Mariner got in confused with his teammate and ordered him off the pitch, despite Chamberlain telling him he'd got the wrong man. Mariner said he was disappointed with the decision. Yeah, we bet. Those were Copper 90's top 10 worst refereeing decisions of all time. Have your team been lumbered with one even worse than those? Let us know in the comments below and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Copper 90.